Hello friends, this is Rajiv Sharma. The subject matter of today's video editorial, political commentary, strategic analysis, is the issue of migrant workers. And to explain the topic in one sentence, Karnataka government gives Khulja Simpson code to Modi government on how to solve migrant workers issue. Now the details. Last night, Karnataka government took an amazing decision. It stopped all special Shramik trains, Shramik rail, which are supposed to carry migrant workers back to their native places for the next 1 week. This followed after a delegation of construction industries met the Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa. And today, Karnataka government announced a stimulus package of 1,610 crore for a lot of people, including drivers, flowers, left sellers, workers in unorganized sector, including migrant workers. And according to this package, they will get 5,000 rupees each in their account by direct bank transfer. And the trains were cancelled. Till yesterday, Karnataka had already moved over 1 lakh migrant workers back to their native places by trains and by buses. But many more lakh migrant workers continue to remain in the state who want to go to their native place, mostly from Bihar. Now, I believe that this is a potential Khulja Simpson code which the Yediyurappa government has given to the central government led by Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And I think the central government should take the cue and implement it nationwide. Well, I will explain that. I'll come to that later. But the Congress has already been, the reaction of Congress has been fast and furious as expected. And Congress leader D.K. Shivakumar has said that migrant workers are not bonded laborers. They can't be detained contrary to their wishes. Well, I think that this particular matter can be resolved, and the Yediyurappa government has a whale of an opportunity to resolve this issue, provided they play their cards smartly, very well, and they silence the critics, particularly the Congress, which is the main opposition party there. For example, Congress has said that they have taken note of this Chief Minister's proposal of giving 5,000 rupees per month to migrant workers apart from job. Congress stance is that this is not enough, and which is correct, it is not enough. So I think the Yediyurappa government should stitch their coat around the button here and should do something to make sure that migrant workers do not leave. Why? Now comes the crunch point. First of all, if there is an exodus of migrant workers then rest assured, even in the post-lockdown period, there will be labor pangs, there will be labor shortages, which will seriously impact, adversely affect all industries, particularly construction, transport, and retailers, e-commerce companies, where they generally the migrant workers work as delivery boys for taking the stuff to the last mile. Now, if the migrant workers go now, they won't be back before several months. So, supposing the nationwide lockdown is lifted on 18th of May, and by then the migrant workers are allowed to leave. So, who will manage all those activities where all these industries are solely dependent on migrant workers? Well, according to CRISIL survey, Indian workforce is 465 million, that is 46 crore 50 lakhs, out of which 415 million, that is 41 crore 50 lakhs, are in the informal sector. Most of them are migrant workers. Now you can imagine that so much depends on migrant workers, particularly the states. And don't forget that the government of India's total, out of the total GDP of the government of India, 66%, and the total revenue of the government of India, 66% comes from states. So this is not to be forgotten. The post-lockdown situation also has to be adroitly addressed. Now, let me give you more statistics. Supposing that the trains were to continue for transporting the migrant workers from the host state to their home states. Now, have you any idea? Have you done the mathematics? How long will it take? How many trains will it take? Supposing one train carries 1,000 migrant workers at the best, considering the social distance norms. You can't pack them like sardines. So considering that one train carries 1,000 migrant workers, it will take at least 9,000 trains to carry all the migrant workers to their native places. Why? Because according to the 2016-17 economic survey analysis of railway passenger data estimates, it says that the annual interstate migration movement is 9 million. That is almost 1 crore, 90 lakhs. That is, these data are 2016-17. So, it is quite possible that this data, that this figure may have crossed 1 crore mark. Now, this is since 2011. The figures are that the 9 million people are using the railways per annum since 2011. So, and of course, the trains have done away with the South's linguistic barrier. The South's linguistic barrier has been left redundant. Now, can you run 9,000 trains? And how long will it take? And in any case, you have to bother about the post-lockdown. So friends, I think the Yediyurappa government should consider sweetening the deal for migrant workers. And if they are given a decent income straight away. And if they have the job, the shelter and the money in their pocket, I see no reason why they would like to leave. Because in any case, in their home state, they do not have a gold mine in their home state. They will come back. Eventually, 3 months later, 4 months later, according to one survey, 40% of the workforce will be back after 3 months. So, why not retain them? Why disturb this railway and bus movement, interstate movement? Why risk this movement, whether it is interstate rail movement or interstate bus movement? And why precipitate the coronavirus threat further? So, friends, thank you very much, and I hope that you will find this video editorial thought-provoking. You will like it, and you will subscribe to my channel if you have not already. Thank you.